In the upper regions, Indus flows through the high desert of Baltistan. It originates in Tibet and flows down to the Arabian Sea, draining these high mountains. It carries with it the rich alluvial soil which it spreads in the plains of Punjab and Sindh. Here it carves its way along the Platonic masses, separating the Himalayan range from the Karakoram and the Hindu Kush. The all-weather Karakoram Highway is built along its course. Karakorams are the youngest mountains in the world and are still in their formative stage. Nestled in the mountains is the valley of Hunza with Karimabad as its capital. The people of Hunza are known as Hunza Kurds. They have fair complexions, light-colored hair, and legend has it that they are the descendants of five of Alexander's soldiers. The ancient village of Ganesh is strategically situated at a point where the valley becomes very narrow and might have served as a defense post in the olden times. The people of Ganesh call these rocks Haldikesh, which means the place of the male ibex. The ancient rock carvings tell us of a time when there was an abundance of ibex in these mountains, and hunters on horsebacks used primitive weapons for the hunt. With the advent of the gunpowder and the rifle, the numbers of the ibex started to decline, and eventually the ibex became an endangered species. In spring, when vegetation begins to grow, the ibex descend in the valley for food. They are lean, weak, and hungry. Their winter coats are lighter in color and very thickly matted. They feed voraciously and are not disturbed by human presence. The Himalayan ibex differs from the alpine or the European ibex by the shape of its horns, which in an adult male grow much longer, curving around in an arc. The European ibex weighs more than the Himalayan ibex and is a bigger animal. However, both the female and the male have a beard which grows up to 8 inches in length. Spring is also the time when the game watchers of the department keep watch over the herds. Ibexes have a very keen sense of smell, and human smell is a deterrent. This herd ran away when the breeze carried our smell towards them. we come upon several small herds and notice that there are a lot of young ibexes amongst them, mostly between 2 and 4 years of age. Of course, there are older males too, which may be classified as trophy-sized males. IUCN and WWF, with the help of the Wildlife Department, instituted the trophy hunting program. This not only stopped the decline in the ibex population, but the numbers are increasing quite rapidly. The trophy hunting program works like this. Villages voluntarily stop hunting the ibex. They assign their hunters to look after the ibex herds in their areas. The local hunter now becomes the local conservationist. The Wildlife Department issues hunting permits for a fee. 80% of the money collected as hunting fee is given to the village where the hunt is carried out. In this way, the villagers get paid to look after the ibex. The hunters get their trophy, and the ibex population increases because only a few animals are hunted each year. Travelling on the Karakoram Highway has its share of difficulties. A landslide has blocked the road and the army engineers are clearing the debris. This causes some delay. It is late summer and we are going back up to Upper Hunza to look for the ibex herds. This is the breeding season and we hope to see lots of females with their kids. When we get to Upper Hunza, the weather changes and it starts to snow. At the Khunjrab National Park, we are told we need special permits for filming wildlife. It appears that the director of the park has instructed his staff to send us back to Gilgit. The next day being a holiday, we drive all the way back to Gilgit. Back in the 6th century BC, Buddhism thrived in Gilgit. Gilgit in some old dialect means come go and was called that because it was an important staging area on the Silk Route. Here traders from all over came and went. It has since grown into a major market. After spending 3 days in Gilgit, we get the necessary permissions to go back to the Khunjrab National Park. Visitors are allowed inside the park on payment of a small fee, and they all carry cameras too. What's so different about us? Being summers, the road from China is constantly in use by lorries carrying Chinese exports to Pakistan and beyond. This traffic frightens wildlife away and we drive around looking for ibex. At the top of the pass at an altitude of 5,000 meters is the border between Pakistan and China. we are once again hit by bad weather and it snows. We wanted to trek out looking for the ibex herds, but were told we were not allowed to leave the road for filming. We come across a herd of domesticated yaks. Yaks share the pasture with the ibex, and in recent years the numbers of yaks has been restricted so that they do not overgraze the pastures. Further down we come across a community of marmots too. Marmots are in the food chain for the carnivores of the area. At last, we were able to see a small kid with its mother ibex, and it made us forget the frustrations created by the bottlenecks. It's winter now and it's season for mating. We are in Upper Hunza and have decided not to go to the Khunjrab National Park because of our past experiences there. We've seen a herd of ibex high up on the ridge, and we hope to get a close look at them as they descend in the evening. In the meantime, we've been invited to tea at the home of Gada Muhammad, who is a hunter turned conservator. He makes tea for us and serves us home-baked bread called fiti. In the evening, we trek up the mountain under the watchful eyes of our guide and see a herd of ibex. There are several young males, a couple of large males, and many females in the herd. A large male cleverly maneuvers his harem of five females who are almost ready for mating. He makes his play by touching, licking, nudging, and butting. I guess you can call it foreplay. A younger male enters the scene hoping for some action. He is quickly dispatched and the dominion secured. Last seen, the large male had separated one female from the rest and was directing her up the garden path. We are glad to say that in the course of the year we've seen the positive effect of trophy hunting.